Hello, everyone. Today we're back with another episode of our newest series here on the Carson-Noah vlog channel. It's Noah's Product Reviews, where I review products you probably don't care about, but just in case there's like one person in the audience that is, we're doing it anyways. And I was thinking, since I had kind of the little camera setup from the last video we did about our Galaxy's Edge R2 unit, and I promised to review some of the stuff you saw on that shelf, I thought we'd just go ahead and do it right now. So today we're going to be taking a look at three of the Galaxy's Edge creatures from the creature stall at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, and we'll take a look at them in this video, so let's get rolling. Toys, or some of them are plushes, some of them are puppets, some of them are just squeak toys. We're going to take a look at the packaging, and like our droid from last time, it's kind of this immersive packaging. So you can see here, it is a crate formed out of cardboard, of course. But you can see, it's very nice. There's some data pad detailing. You can see there, oh, that's upside down. The creature's name, along with a logo in the Star Wars language of Arabesh. It's not actually a language, it's just their spelling. And then you can see it on the other side there, too. And yeah, it's just a foldable box, very nice detailing. It has a nice, like, weathering to it. It looks like metal from a distance. That's about it for the packaging, though. And let's get on to the actual creatures, and let's just, you know, review them. Now, first of our three creatures, First of our three creatures, we're going to be taking a look at the wart. Not that kind of wart. This is a creature, for those of you that are actually Star Wars fans, may recognize as one of the creatures from the Return of the Jedi. It was the creature in front of Jabba's palace that stuck its tongue out. Let's see if we can. And ate that poor little frog thing, if you remember that. If you don't, you probably just think I'm crazy. But as you just saw, it does have that nice feature where you press down on the back and it launches a plastic tongue out. Close up of the tongue. And this is just a really nice example of the detailing of Galaxy's Edge merchandise. It's very detailed. Of course, it's almost immersive merchandise. It's not like normal Disney Parks merchandise where it's just kind of like a, I don't know, maybe like a Funko Pop with a logo. They don't have any of that kind of stuff in Galaxy's Edge. It's all heavily themed. Even the tag, you can see here, they're all the same tags except for the details, so won't bother pointing those out later. Please focus. I don't know if we're going to get that to focus. But yeah, even the tags are immersive. So you can just tell, like, it's just a really high quality product. And give it a little spin around. See, that looks detailed. That looks good enough. The camera quality there. See, very nice. The eyes are very nice on this guy too. And yeah, it's just a really nice kind of figure. This is made out of a vinyl rubber kind of material, and the tongue, of course, is made of plastic. But then, now that we got this guy out of the way, let's take a look at the next ones. We'll just slide him over here. Let's move this Coke bottle into the actual frame. Grab him. Knock something over. This is the Puffer Pig, and a lot of you probably casual Star Wars fans won't even recognize this thing, and that's because it never actually appeared in a film as of 2020, but it appeared in the TV show Star Wars Rebels, so that's where this thing's from. It's also made of the same rubbery material as our wart, and its main function is... It's a squeak toy. It's not a dog toy, don't get me... Don't get that confused, because this is pretty expensive for a squeak toy. It's like $20, I believe. These are all pretty expensive. There's more creatures even to the line, which we'll talk about later. But it's really nicely detailed overall. You can see the nice airbrushing on the top there. I'm really hoping this is focusing, because I don't want to redo this video. You can see on the bottom of the neck, the little hole where the squeaker is. It's got this nice little proboscis-like mouth, two little horns. And that's about it for this one. It's probably the most simple of all the creatures in the Galaxy's Edge creature line. But yeah, let's get on to my favorite and probably the best of the creatures. It's the Porg. Yeah, of course, you probably all know this guy, little furry guy from the Star Wars Last Jedi. Pretty heavily promoted. Makes for a pretty good toy, too, you can see. There's some more Porg merchandise up there. It's harder than it looks, pointing there. But this is just such a detailed kind of plush of this guy. And as you saw a few seconds ago, I was actually manipulating the wings and the mouth. And that's because, this might look a little weird, but there's a pole coming out of the bottom. That is not going to go well. Someone's going to make weird comments out of that. But you stick your hand up the... This is getting more awkward as it goes on. You stick your hand up its rear, pretty much, up the bottom. I don't have any way else to say that. And there's two prongs, almost. Two little handles. And that... The one on the left side, or I guess you're right, manipulates both the wings, which is a nice function. And the other one moves the mouth, which simultaneously activates a little voice box, which makes him do one of, I think, several phrases. You can go. You can just, it's a really nice puppet. It's really nicely done as well. Like, even you can see little feet, which hang down. If you're wondering, well, does this thing actually stand? Because those legs really wobbly. Yes, it actually does. It might take a second to get to stand. There you go. You can see the pole on the bottom actually supports our guy here. But that's really, I guess, it for all of our creatures. Come off the side. That was a weird face. Of course, as I said earlier, there's actually more to this line. I believe there's the Wampa and the Tauntaun from, of course, Empire Strikes Back, which are ones that I'd like to get in the future. There's a Rathtar from The Force Awakens, which are those kind of amorphous blobs. There's one on the shelf back. Our Porg is making noises. There's one on the shelf right where I'm pointing there. There's one of those, too. It's electronic. It kind of shakes around. There's a Lothcat. Lothcat, yeah. Which is from Star Wars Clone Wars and Star Wars Rebels as well. It's like a cat. I believe that's the most popular of them, because that's the one I always see people going out of the shop with, mainly because it looks like a cat, so it's kind of an almost recognizable thing. And then there's a few other smaller ones in there, like a Dewback and a Bantha. You'll recognize those if you've seen Star Wars at all or know anything about it. But finally, there's a Kowakian monkey lizard. Yeah, you probably don't know what that is, but if you remember in Return of the Jedi with Jabba the Hutt and his palace, he had that little guy, little lizard monkey thing that sat on his throne, Salacious Crumb. They have those. They're animatronic, though. They're kind of similar to some of the things you can buy at Pandora, the World of Avatar, at Disney's Hollywood Studios in Florida, the Avatar Land, where they sit on your shoulder. You have a little button kind of thing. I just had something that looked like it, but I put it away. But it's a little button pretty much attached to a cord that goes to the little creature on your shoulder, and you can press it and it moves its head, all that kind of stuff. But I'd like to get that one too. That'd be a good review. But so far, my impressions on the Galaxy's Edge creatures, they're probably some of the coolest Star Wars pieces of memorabilia out there. And there is a lot of Star Wars memorabilia, whether you're talking about, like, there's, of course, the Lego stuff, which everyone knows about. Just pull that out of absolutely nowhere. Of course, there's, like, the Funko Pop you can see there. There's tons of Funkos. There's even a Galaxy's Edge Funko. If you want to see that, please comment down below. So far, these are looking great. Everything from Galaxy's Edge so far is looking great, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any other suggestions for merchandise that you want to see, stuff that you think I might own, maybe something you see in the background you'd like to maybe take a look at, heck, maybe that X-Wing I just showed you want me to take a look at, I'd like to keep this series going. I do like merchandise reviews. That's about it for this video. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, all that kind of stuff. Please share this channel with people you know, I guess, Star Wars fans, anyone really. We're pretty desperate. But thank you, and I'll see you guys on the next one.